Good evening. I'd like to open the Sewer Study Committee for the Town of Deerfield, April 20th at 6 p.m. here at the town offices at 8 Conway Street in South Deerfield. On our agenda tonight, we're going to review and approve the minutes of the meeting of 3/23/2017. And some of the old business, we're going to continue discussion on capital improvement plans and the next step, our Headworks project, the Captain Lathrop Pump Station, continued discussion on sewer rate options and the next step, respond to questions to Dave Prickett, consultant, and the rate study, continued discussion on the establishment of management areas, discuss the next step on the funding options, Mass Works Headworks project, design for repair replacement of the Captain Lathrop Pump Station, an engineer study of the Old Deerfield and South Deerfield wastewater treatment facilities. So where do we want to start?
Minutes.
Anybody?
Minutes.
Everybody have a chance to look at the minutes?
Yes.
Yep. Anyone want to make a motion?
I'll move the minutes to accept the March 23rd minutes.
Second. Any more discussion? No. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
I abstain because I wasn't here for most of the meeting. So.
Okay.
Again?
Minutes should be ours.
I don't remember where we left off, so why don't we just start in on capital improvement plans, the next steps, the Headworks project. I've seen a couple of correspondence with Dave Prickett, and I know that, Bruce, you've had some conversations with the people at Weston.
Yeah. And Weston Sampson, I think I emailed everybody a copy of the responses.
Yep.
Everybody need a copy?
Nope, I got it.
I'm good.
So we asked him several questions relative to the project they did and what they are still willing to do, what they're able to do. We asked them if they could downsize the Headworks project at a minimum to eliminate the back truck area, and they said they could. There'd be no charge for that. They also said that they would resubmit the application, either reduced or as it currently exists, at no charge to Mass Works. I asked them how we could make the application stronger. They didn't believe that the pumping station upgrade would necessarily improve the application significantly. They believed that if you had an economic development project or a job creation, job retention project, that might, because there are different categories in Mass Works. Infrastructure is just one of the several categories. So if you have one of the other categories in the application, it would make a stronger application. At this point in time, we don't, but that's up to the town. And so at this point, if we want to resubmit the application, the sewer commissioners should contact Weston Sampson and ask them to resubmit. Now, there's a whole bunch of letters, support letters, that need to be prepared. They were prepared last time. I think they could be, I'm not sure who has the application to begin with.
Okay.
You should look at the last year's application, take the support letters and resend them out to the front, to the individuals that signed them, and just have them redate them. And then it's just a resubmission, and that's done in October. If the sewer commissioners want it redesigned to eliminate the larger building. I think they're willing to do that for free. But if they want the headworks project itself redesigned, that's going to be a fee. And you're going to need to have them come in and discuss what you're looking for alternatives. So I, we also asked them, per their contract, because I hadn't seen it, what were the deliverables that they were required to submit? And they were, they responded back, paper copies of the, they have not submitted the specifications yet, but they have submitted the plans. The specifications will be submitted to the town shortly. They did say that they had several engineers that, if not in their Connecticut office, in their other offices, that could easily handle this project. And they're willing to meet with us if we want to go further with them. This, that's a decision for the sewer commissioners. They also, I also asked them to review and redefine the next steps as they proposed in the 2015 presentation. They did that, and they listed the rate study, the collection system, GIS mapping is number two, collection system rehabilitation planning, that was the old Deerfield, South Deerfield, deciding what we want to do with those plants. And I think that fee was about $100,000. Then they looked at the industrial pretreatment program, planning phase for sewer extension. They, these were in lower priorities. But the rate study, which we have, which the town has contracted with David Pritchett, was completed not by this committee.
Correct.
It was completed by another subcommittee or committee, and they're the ones that need to make a recommendation to David Pritchett for his final memorandum. It's my understanding David Pritchett's been paid in full. And
do you have an idea of who was on that committee? Because I should know.
You were?
This is the first I've heard of it.
You never met with anybody, David Pritchett, for the rate study analysis?
When?
Last year?
No.
6 months ago?
No.
No. I think,
so
I don't.
It was the town administrator and?
It was Doug Finn and
Kevin.
That's it?
That sounds familiar.
That's all you call?
That's my understanding, yeah.
Because
so they need to review that draft, because we had no input on it.
Right.
The project's complete, according to David Pritchett.
Yep.
Except for the final memorandum. The question is, do we want to do another rate study? I don't think it's in the benefit of the community to do another one. So the collection system GIS mapping and updates, that had a price tag, certain dollars per year. I think it was $20,000 or $30,000 per year. It does exist currently. There are GIS maps with sewer manholes shown. That's it. But no inverts, no coordinates. I'm not sure if we have them all. No pipe sizes, no condition of the pipe. And all that would be done in the GIS mapping. So then I asked a question about Captain Lathrop pump station, what it would cost to design to replace the existing pump station with a new one or just upgrade the electrical boards and associated items. It said they have examined the probable cost of such work and feel that a complete replacement of the station only would cost about $500,000. Control panel replacement with minor refurbishment of existing systems would be likely to exceed $100,000. Pump would like to add another 50K. Design engineering typically 10 to 12%, and the budget should be $60,000 to $70,000 for that type of project.
Well, as far as the Captain Lathrop pump station, we've had a couple people review it, and I believe that we're going to go down the road, we're just going to buy a new pump, a different type of pump, one that can take care of all of these things that can shred it all. As far as electrical...
So the pump itself will shred everything?
Yes.
Okay.
That's what we were informed. Kevin and I have been invited to go look at these pumps in action in Agawam, but the minute that the guy looked at what we had, he said that basically we just have nothing more than glorified sump pumps.
Yeah.
And he says, and that's why you keep having the problem.
Well, that's all it was intended to do, is pump liquid.
Right. Well, I noticed that there's a basket that's at the end of that pipe that Kevin told me was cleaned 2 days ago, and the basket's approximately 24 inches square,
yeah,
with 1.5-inch holes, and the thing was totally clogged with these disposable wipes, and the fluid was bilging over the top.
So a grinder pump might do it, but I think you, whatever.
Well, yeah, I haven't taken this apart, but the pumps that are in there just basically have an impeller on the bottom.
No, they're
that
just...
The pump that's supposed, that we're going to be looking into, actually has two stainless steel serrated blades below the pump, and it all turns as a unit, and it supposedly will shred this up and has larger ports, so it will push everything right through. You know, downstream, that's another issue, but that will deal with that pump station.
So what does it do to dental floss?
It's supposed to pass everything right through. You know, will it get wrapped up around the shaft? I don't know. It depends on the length of the dental floss.
Whatever. That is an option you're looking at?
Yeah. Some of the electrical work, the panels, it's... I don't know, but I don't believe that it's as antiquated as we think. There's these relays in there that I was told were obsolete and very difficult to come by, and they're very expensive. And after meeting with John over there, I went online and I found them for $9 a piece. You can buy them 100 at a time if you want. So, and I also looked for all of the breaker panels, and they're all available. As far, you know, I'm not an electrician, but when Kevin opened up the box, there's nothing rusty, there's nothing corroded, everything looks nice and neat and labeled.
So it's pretty much the reason is that when the pump stops because it's clogged,
it blows circuits and relays and whatever. Yeah. Or if it doesn't actually clog it, it's beginning to, and it just slows it down.
Okay.
But it's because of the way it's set up. This other pump is supposed to... it's halfway between, I guess you'd call it like a centrifugal pump and a mud sucker type thing. I don't know. I haven't seen the information.
Okay.
But I've got a meeting next week with a contractor to talk about that, as well as one of those, I know his favorite thing. I keep calling it auger monster, but that's a brand name of it.
All right.
There's another one, pretty much the same thing, from a Franklin Miller company that they were talking about as well. One of the things that both of these guys talked to me about was the amount of flow that goes into that thing. And is it around 500,000 gallons a day?
What, into the plant?
It's out Deerfield.
Yeah.
They figured, or looking around, they thought that one of these things would really work well. And after talking with the engineer from the company, the idea of having the grinder in front of it, he said he didn't believe that it would serve much of a purpose because there's not enough stuff going through it, that the screen itself would take care of most of whatever. But that's something that, you know, I'm not saying to eliminate the headworks project, but this is something that can be purchased and installed rather quickly to relieve a lot of the ragging issues that's happening, that's going on down there. But I do have a meeting next week with a contractor and an engineer, and I don't know if he's from Franklin Miller or if he's just from this other company. Can't think of what his name is. Suez, maybe? I don't know. Also, there's, where did I put his name? I had a conversation today with a local resident. His name is John Schmel. He lives on Hillside Road, and he's the executive director of the Springfield Water and Sewer Department. And he'd like to, you know, come and talk with us, and actually he said he'd like to be part of our committee going on. And he can also bring us information as to what they've been doing to deal with different problems. John Lukowski has invited any of us that want to go see these things in action. And one of the things that I was concerned about, you know, we talked, you know, how much money are we going to spend to do something like this, and, you know, housing it and stuff like that. And he said, all the ones that got Nagawam are right outside. I said, well, don't they freeze in the wintertime? And he goes, no. It's because they run all the time. So, I don't know, it's just something else.
So they grind it up, put it, they grind it up and let that go into the aeration tank? Is that right?
No, they don't, it doesn't grind it up. There's, I don't know, how big are those canals? 24 inches maybe?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. And it sits on an angle.
Right.
And all the water goes through there. And
right.
There's like a, I don't know what you want to call it, a funnel type thing, because it goes from the outside of the channel and it goes to a 15-inch stainless steel tube. And it has that spiral thing, and it pulls it up and it sprays the water on it. And then everything that's in there falls into a dumpster. And it can be, that dumpster can go to a regular landfill.
So how are you going to get the dumpster from the current influence channel to have that be in a position for, say, a garbage truck to come and get it? And how are you going to prevent that from freezing?
I asked him about it. He says it doesn't freeze because it's,
really?
It's moved all the time. Yeah.
Wet stuff out in the open in January will not freeze. Seriously.
But it doesn't stay there long enough. That's what I'm saying.
So the question is, how much
how
much material are we talking about? A two-yard dumpster? 10-yard dumpster?
It's a pretty small one. It's like a 2-yard dumpster.
So it's picked up daily?
It can be, yes. But that's just...
So I'm looking at this picture, and so what it does is it removes the ragging material? It pulls the ragging material out of the channel.
Right.
And then dumps it into a...
And it just falls. It just, when it gets to the opening,
when it gets to the top, it drops into the...
Yep. So along there, it sprays it off. But, you know, they're going to give me... This is kind of what I had looked at a long time ago, but I know Keith didn't really speak too highly of that whole setup.
But mainly because since the beginning of the plants, there have been grinders of some kind or another, and none of them have been effective in keeping most of the material out of the system. The other part of it is I don't believe that removes grease or grit. It still lets all that through.
Well, it doesn't,
and that's problematic.
I'm not an expert at this, obviously. But
I am, and it doesn't.
Well, the grease, they say, will go through in small parts. But if it comes in any large chunks, it will be pulled out. But a lot of the grit, if any of the grit is an eighth of an inch or larger, the brushes will pull this right up and it will fall out. Will it get rid of all of it? Probably not. But it would get rid of some of it,
mm-hmm.
You know. But anyways, I'm going to, you know, follow. Just to let you guys know, I'm going to follow up on this and just...
So what does that thing cost? What is that?
I don't really know. The one that I was looking at was about $190,000, and this is supposed to be substantially cheaper. So I said, well, what's substantially cheaper? He says, I'm not sure. He says he thinks that they paid about $145,000 for the last one they bought, the people out of Springfield.
And how long did they last?
They're over 10 years old. The only part that tends to wear out is... If you get the one that has the grinder in the front, that depending on what comes through, those heads can wear out. And the other company that I talked with, it was a while ago, they have an exchange program, because this thing, there's only four bolts that hold it in. And, you know, you have to redo the wires, take the four bolts and just pick it out, and you put the new one right in. So it's really not down for more than 10 minutes at a time. And you can take the old one and ship it back and, you know.
How about the auger and the brushes?
They're also interchangeable, but I don't know, you know, exactly how long they last.
Are they subject to picking up all these wipes and floss and so forth, so they have to be cleaned as well?
No, supposedly you're not, you don't have to clean them, because the auger is some sort of stainless steel, and there's like little bristles at the end, and it just, this thing is perforated all the way around, and it sprays water on it continually, and as the stuff works up, it's supposed to be dewatered, don't ask me how long, because it's probably not in there all that long, and then falls into that dumpster. But I don't know, I don't understand the term. Is dewatering a watering process to clean the bad stuff off of the solids?
Or no, is it dewatering is watering being removed from.
Getting removed, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you don't have a dumpster full of water.
Exactly, exactly.
Yeah. Are you familiar with this system? Have you seen it in operation?
I've seen it on YouTube.
Then I would suggest that maybe Keith go down when you go down or something, and yeah. Keith take a look at it, since he does run the department. I mean, you're the one that's going to have to deal with it, so I'd like to see.
Or not.
Well, I know you're not in favor of it, but.
No, I'm not.
You know, but
it's not built for the future. It's just sort of what we already have, modernized a little bit. But it's not going to remove grit and grease, and it's not going to, that alone precludes diffused aeration in the future, and that's going to be needed.
And I'm not saying it's not, but unfortunately, these cans have been kicked down the road for so long. You need to do something, even if it's so.
That's why I'm not in favor of adding that.
Even if it's only going to hold it off for 4 or 5 years.
That's why I'm not in favor of adding that, because the bar screen was $100,000. The only thing that jacked that price up was the building to keep it warm. That was it. And now we're talking about spending $150 on a grinder.
Did this would replace the bar screen?
I mean, according to him, it will, but according to me, it will not.
Well, I think where I'm getting it all along is this is something that can be done now. And
that is a waste of town money, excuse me. That's how I feel about it. And I don't see how you're going to spend $150,000 on something that's only going to be there for 5 years, when you could spend something the same amount and then a little more to put it in a warm building and have it last 20 or 30.
Well, that might be true, Keith, but that also might not happen for a year or two. And this
so
is what
be
I'm
it.
Saying.
I would much rather wait another 2 years to get something that's right for this town, so they get maximum bang out of their buck, instead of wasting $150,000 plus to have something that's going to be problematic and not really do the job that needs to be done. That's how I feel.
Why do they use four of them right in Agawam?
I don't know why they do in Agawam, but our process is not Agawam's process.
Okay, well, first off, begin with.
And why do you insist upon this grinder when I keep telling you it's a mistake, Kip?
I'm not insisting on it, but I've met
you. Are. You keep looking for someone to agree with you so that you can prove to everyone that what I'm saying is BS and what you're saying is the right solution.
That's not true, Keith. What I'm trying to do is come up with a solution that's right away instead of spending $3.5 million.
No.
You, Kevin,
we don't want
and,
knee-jerk
yes, sir.
Quick fixes.
Please,
we
let me
want
finish.
Long-term
and you
solutions.
Spend all this time telling us what we need, and I asked you, how do you pay for it? You said, send the bill to me.
I was kidding, Kevin.
I understand that. But we have a problem we have to deal with here, and we have a certain amount of
you
money to
deal
with.
You have a problem we have to deal with. That's correct. And why do you even know about it? Because I told you. Why did no one else tell this town about it for 30 years? That's also a problem. And why are you discounting what I'm telling you so quickly, yet you're willing to spend nearly $200,000 on a piece of equipment that you just said would probably only be there for 4 or 5 years? That is a waste of taxpayer money. Better to wait 2 years and do it right and have a long-term infrastructure that will last. You don't buy a brand new car for 5 years, you lease it. You don't buy it. You buy a car that you're going to hang on to for at least 10 years or 100,000. Everyone knows that. You don't spend nearly $250,000 on something you're only going to have for 4 or 5 years. And who are you kidding? Once it's in, it's not going to be 4 or 5 years, it's going to be 20. It's not going to do the job that you're going to need to do down the road when EPA and DEP comes to you and says, you're going to have to start moving nitrogen and phosphorus from your stream. Are we going to be able to do that with a grinder? No. We're going to be able to do that with air, diffused aeration in place. That can't happen with any of this material going into the tank that a grinder will let through. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Why do you not hear that? That's a question for you.
I hear it, but I've also spoke with a lot of other engineers that totally disagree with your point of view. They don't say
You've spoken with two people.
That's not
and
true.
One of them is in Agawam. And they have a completely different system in Agawam.
Well,
are theirs indoors? No, you say they're not. But they don't freeze in January either, right?
That's what they told me.
And you believe that?
Why shouldn't I?
Why should you not believe me?
I do believe you, but I'm saying that there's a different point of view here.
And but you're willing to spend nearly $250,000 on a different point of view rather than listen to somebody you have hired to be your guy who's down there taking care of things.
This could solve a lot of your problems. Not
no,
all
it
of
cannot.
Them.
It can create a whole lot of new problems. That's not going to solve anything for me. That's what I'm saying to you. How is that going to solve anything, Kip?
Aren't the rags a big problem for you?
They certainly are. They are the biggest.
And this wouldn't get rid of them?
It might get rid of some of them for a while.
Well,
just like our dimmer that we have right now did for a while.
They're only an eighth of an inch big. How are the rags going to get through those holes?
You know what? Have fun with your meeting. I'm done.
Don't forget your jacket.
Yeah, thanks. I'm just so tired of this. Do what you want to do. You're going to do it anyway. I don't care.
Keith.
Go for it, man.
I'm adding your...
Go for it.
I'm adding your notes to the minutes. Is that right?
Yes, please do.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well...
No, Kip, I don't know what it costs us, but I think what we need to do is spend about $10,000 or so to get some independent engineer who doesn't work for Weston and Sampson and doesn't work for anybody that we've got under contract, and just to take a look as to where we should go forward and where what, because unless you do it his way, he's going to continue to expound and expound and expound until it's done his way. And I think you need to hire somebody independent that I don't pick, you don't pick, but you know, we put out an RFP for somebody to come in and do a quick look and try to figure out what's the best way going forward, and somebody who's not looking to get the job and what have you, because you're never going to keep Keith happy, right? And in my opinion.
No, I agree with you, Bob. But we have to define what we're going to ask the engineer to review. Are we going to take the existing Headworks project versus something else and have them do an evaluation? Is that
That's
what we're
right.
asking?
That's what I'm trying to say is that...
So in other words, we're going to hire an engineer to evaluate an alternative to what Weston Sampson has designed.
Come give us alternates.
All the alternatives.
Yeah, as to what is...
It would do the exact same thing that Weston Sampson's system will do.
I want to make sure we're in compliance and all that. There's many ways of doing these types of things. I don't know what they are.
I'm not that
familiar, but what I'm trying to say is unless you do it Keith's way, there'll be a roadblock going forward.
So the only roadblock is
no.
He has no voice other than he's an employee of the town. He's not one of the townspeople who's paying the bills.
Well, I agree with you.
So if an engineer says this system is better than what we currently have designed, and we get it designed, we spend the money to design it, we put it, either go to Mass Works if we have time, or put it out to bid, and we build it, and it works, we're golden. So that's what the process, we're looking to do a feasibility study on analysis of whatever we have designed now, what alternatives can be proposed.
Why don't we, as part of that, include Keith's argument? Keith's side of it?
Yep.
Kip's side of it?
Oh, yeah.
Say if these two are...
Well, we can't.
In addition to any others. Why not?
Because neither one of them are engineers. I think you have to start with a basis. And the basis is we have, we paid, the town has paid for a headworks project. It's over-designed because the building is twice as big as it needs to be. We know all these things. But we have a design that has been stamped by a civil engineer. We need somebody, another engineer, to say, okay, we want whatever they did to do, we want you to do the exact same thing. Come up with alternatives to what they did. But we want the same end result.
I think there might possibly just, maybe if there's time to do that beforehand, is to ask them where they have a similar system with the design that they have right now, and pull those places and see whether they're having problems.
With the system we have right now?
What we have designed right now. And see if they're having problems. If they're not having problems, then you know what? Maybe we're better off to spend a little extra money if it takes. If it's a system that's guaranteed to work, then is against going to something that's a little cheaper that should cure the problem. So I would say, you know, Weston and Sampson's large enough where I'm sure they must have a similar design systems somewhere. And find out truly, you know, okay, if that is working from the people that have to operate it.
Are there any issues or not?
Right.
But
I feel like we're straying again. I mean, if we had gotten the MassWorks grant, we would have built this thing.
Yep.
Why are we second guessing ourselves now?
Because I think we're looking for it.
Because there's been too many options laid on the table.
Right.
Yeah. And well, trust me, I'm not saying that this thing is going to solve all the problems. All I was looking to do, Bruce, is to get rid of the rags and before it gets into the system. It's not going to deal with all of the things, and I understand that. This is just something that can be done quick and easy to get rid of the majority of the problems. This is what I heard was one of the biggest issues that they had was all this rag material, getting around the pump motors, burning them down, burning them up, or making the electrical bill go higher because it's straining, and then, you know, people have to go out on these things and derag it. That's what this is supposed to do.
Yep.
It's not supposed to create any of the other things.
That's what the headworks is supposed to do.
And
it seems like that's that decision was already made. I don't understand why we're rehashing this again. For years we've been listening to Weston and Sampson. For years we've talked about it. And if that we had gotten the grant, we would have built it.
Jack, I'm not saying, and like after Bruce talked earlier about, you know, opening up discussions with Weston and Sampson and downscaling the building, stuff like that, I didn't oppose that at all.
Right. I'm not in favor of the $3.5 million.
I just started to talk about this to inform the board that I've been meeting with these other people because I wanted to see if I could do something.
But there's other alternatives. Yes.
Not necessarily an alternative to Headworks project, but something that's right there. And I just, all the numbers that I saw, you're not going to get the Headworks project for $100,000.
No.
So it's going to be $1 million.
It's going to be $1.5 million.
Exactly.
It was $1.5 million.
Right.
I don't know what it is.
3.2.
This company also, you know, and I'm just throwing options out, that you can lease these things. So, you know, we could not even buy it. You could lease the thing for 6 months to a year to see if that helps get rid of the ragging.
I think for an interim or short-term fix or fix until we have funds to build a headworks project, whether it's this one that's already designed, we've already paid for, or another one that somebody comes up with and designs and we pay for again. Sewer commissioners should lease that, have it installed, and leaves it for a year and see what happens.
Well, it might help with that problem, but.
But I mean, we won't know.
Right, well, that's.
Until we do it. So the issue here is that, I don't think this is a committee issue. Committee is, we're looking at long-term solutions.
Yeah.
You're looking as a sewer commissioner for an interim fix so you can make the current wastewater treatment plant more efficient than it currently is. And I think that's what you guys are supposed to be doing. We're supposed to come up with a long-term solution for the sewer treatment facilities. These short-term solutions might very well work, and they might work for the next 5 or 10 years. If we don't get the Mass Works grant, we might not have to. If it does work, we might not have to fully fund this project. So.
Well.
My feeling is that, like, I agree with Bob in a way, and Bruce, that we need to determine what is designed currently works, or we need to have an alternative design, pay for a study to have an alternative design with the same end result. Because I don't know if anybody disagrees that, I don't think any of us know enough to say that the design that's currently prepared by Weston Sampson is good or better, or there are better ones out there. We hired an engineer to design the system we felt that we needed. That's my impression. To hire somebody else to come up with alternatives, I'm not sure.
Keith, there's a nonprofit organization in Eastern Mass, and they train sewage plant operators, and I can't remember the name of it. And it exists to advise cities and towns on sewage and water distribution problems.
Are you speaking of the Metropolitan Area Planning Commission, the MAPC?
No, it's the American Water Works Association.
But there's so many. I don't know which one you're speaking of in particular.
I can't remember.
Our certification is done through New England Interstate Water Pollution Control Commission. We also have the Massachusetts Water Pollution Control Association that we're all members of, that also help us with information and training. So they kind of work together, NUIPIC and MWPCA. But as far as advising.
So would any of these organizations advise us
on
what direction we should take?
About?
Any of these issues. I mean, because we're talking about hiring another engineer.
See, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
To hire another engineer? Or?
I mean, I don't. You're talking about Bobby.
I'm just saying, it's like a doctor going to a doctor for a second opinion.
But yes.
I'm just saying that, you know, I see Keith's argument. I know what Kippy's talking about, and I'm just.
But his is not a long-term solution.
Nothing.
And Kip agrees it's not a long-term solution. So the question maybe we should pose to Keith is, what was designed by Weston Sampson, headworks only, is that the state-of-the-art system that can be designed?
I'm sure that could be maybe perhaps a little bit more state-of-the-art than that, definitely. But that was a nice middle-of-the-road but basic system.
That was easily maintained?
Very. And it was compact, small, small footprint, quiet, energy efficient, stainless steel. No rust, easy to maintain, very accommodative of strange objects coming through, large, small, big, fluffy, whatever. And it also provided the three basics: grit, separation and removal, grease, separation and removal, rag removal from the channel, and all of that dewatered and compacted, almost dry by the time it's put into it.
What would be the life expectancy of that design?
With just normal maintenance and repair, I would venture to say 30 years. That's common.
Kevin, when you guys were going through the design process with Weston Sampson, did you view any wastewater treatment plants that had this headworks project?
Negative, we did not take a track.
Do you know of any, did they say there were any that they have designed that are similar to this?
Yes.
That we could view?
Yes.
And talk to the operators?
And they aren't that far away, I don't think. So Tony gave us, or sent me a link to a video that showed a recent install, I think it was last year or the year before now, of an identical system that he wanted to put in.
Okay.
In operation.
In operation. Yep. So we could discuss with the operator ease, mm-hmm. maintenance requirements, the cost to put them in, how we did it.
Yeah.
What it cost to put in.
Certainly.
Okay. Can that link be forwarded to us?
Pardon me?
Can you forward that link to the board members?
Yes, I'll look it up and do that.
Appreciate it.
Let's see. It seemed like we're at a position where we have a design, and if it does pass all the questions that we have, and all the questions that our wastewater treatment plant operator has, and our highway superintendent, they're satisfied with what they ended up with the design. And the operators of the system that currently is running that type of system is happy with it. Maybe we should move forward with an application to Mass Works. But also, as Kip said, if there is the ability to lease this intermediate option, we could lease it for a short term, but that's a sewer commissioner's decision, to assist the operators at the wastewater treatment plant to eliminate the extra work that they needed to do. I think that's Kip's intent, is to reduce the manpower requirements and the safety issues and the energy efficiency of the system. That's what Kip's trying to do. So if that can be done on the short-term basis while we're waiting to hear from Mass Works, because typically we apply in October, we don't hear until October, we don't hear That's until correct. Until October. January or February? January? Sorry. When did we hear that we didn't get it? Was it January?
It was like February, so it was right around that.
So I'm not sure the program exists anymore.
Mass Works?
Yeah.
They took it out?
I'll check, but I thought I read that might have been the last year.
An engineer said he still could apply for it.
Yeah, that's what.
You still could?
Yeah, that's okay. What Weston
Sampson
said.
Yeah. All right.
Well, we can look at the video and find out where these other systems are.
Yeah.
So if somebody wants to take a field trip,
I think
it might be able to be arranged. And,
yeah.
And what
the
plant have you
that I worked at in Virginia, it was much larger, granted, but it had the same apparatus just on a much larger scale.
Sure.
And it works fantastic.
Yep.
So, and as an aside, I would like to apologize to the committee for losing my cool. In particular, Mr. Camosa, I apologize to you. I'm sorry. And I did not intend for that to happen. I feel very frustrated about many things right now in the process of this. And I let that get the better of me, and I'm sorry I acted in an unprofessional manner, and I apologize.
Well, thank you. I accept the apology. I understand.
I think we all understand there's a lot of frustration, Keith. So, and I think a lot of us with ourselves are a little frustrated with this whole process. You know, I think a lot of us thought we'd be able to move a lot quicker than what we are, and yet at the same time realize that this is, you know, a major decision, and I think we're all kind of trying to get as much input as we can to make the right decision. And your input is valuable. I don't want to shortchange you by any stretch of the imagination.
Thank you.
And part of the conversation you had missed, and maybe it'll go down a little better, was, and Bruce explained it out very well, that Henry's position, even though he's sitting on the board, is more for a short-term solution if it's necessary, where the board's position is to look for a long-term. And I didn't realize when he was talking about that, he said there is a possibility of just leasing this for a short-term solution if need be. You know, so that, mm-hmm. you know, so that wouldn't be dumping in that ton of money.
So I think we're
permanent type of situation.
Yeah, we're at a crossroads, I think, relative to the Headworks project. We need to decide as a committee whether we recommend to the select board that they reapply with the existing plans that they have, or we decide to reduce the envelope to just include the Headworks project.
Well, didn't you say that Weston Sampson would be willing to do that?
Either way.
Well, the Headworks and the generator.
And the generator.
The generator is a must.
No, it's part of the Headworks application. It was already. So that total application that was resubmitted, they would resubmit for no dollars. What the town would have to do is get all new letters of support, and the application would be resubmitted in October.
That's just for the Headworks, not for the whole.
Headworks and generator.
Yeah, but not for the whole project.
What is the whole project?
What was the rest of it? Expanded balloon to the project.
No. This is just the Headworks.
It'd be just the Headworks.
That's the first thing that needs to be done. That's always been the priority on this committee's.
So that would be phase one of whatever.
Phase one of 20.
If we apply for the grant for just the Headworks, does that preclude us applying for another grant to bring the plants up the snuff?
No.
So if we can do both?
We'd probably not apply to Mass Works for the remainder of the project. The reason is because it's going to be multi-millions of dollars, potentially, depending which way.
Won't they help with part of it? Maybe.
You get in line. And at that point, once you pay an engineer to design something that's $10 million, they're charging you $1 million. And I'm not sure you want to get in line and wait a couple of years for $1 million expenditure. So in that case, you would probably apply to USDA or the State Revolving
Fund. I'll give you a call later. I said I'll give you a call later.
So, but I think the biggest issue we have, is the set of plans that we currently have. If we receive a Mass Works grant, I think everybody agreed we could accept having that size of a project. But if we can't get a Mass Works grant, which we would know this time next year, we have to have something to go out to bid in March or April at the latest. It should have been out to bid in January for a smaller type of project. So I don't think we can ask Weston Sampson to do both. We can ask them to reduce the size, and they'll do it for free and resubmit the application. Or they can resubmit the application as is. I don't think they'll resubmit the application, then downsize the project for us at no fee.
Right, but if we...
Chris may do that. He may do both. Because realistically, whether he'd be reducing the size or keeping the same size at this point in time, they still have to go through the same process to submit the larger one. Again, depending on how deep you get into.
Yeah, but what if we are awarded the larger project in February, he's already gone and spent $5,000 or $6,000 or $7,000 of his money.
Well, like I said, it's worth an ask. Most you can do is say
no. I can ask. But it's really up to the committee what recommendation we make to the selectmen. At least on this one task, I think we need to make a recommendation specifically to get this rolling, because we are April, March, May, June, July, August, and it comes around time to submit again.
I don't understand totally how it all works, but it would sure seem to me that whoever reviews these grant requests, the larger the dollar amount, depending on the amount of people it serves, that could be a swaying factor in their decision-making. So if we go for the bigger one again, there might be a good chance that it gets denied again. I don't know that. But it would seem to me if we applied to them for a smaller one, and when I say smaller, you know, without the building or whatever, there might be a better chance of getting it. I don't know.
I think that'd be a great question to ask Chris, because that's what they do.
Yeah.
Because otherwise we're just speculating.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing, keeping in mind that you're already, no matter what you do, we're at least a year and a half out to do anything right now.
Right.
Because nothing was presented to capital planning or anything else to begin with this year.
No.
So.
But we have no cost at this point. Have no cost even next year.
So if they downsize the project, we applied for the smaller project, we'd be ready to go and pay for it ourselves.
Yes.
So. But it's something has to go through capital planning before.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah,
but capital planning has already recommended it years ago.
Well,
they already recommended the smaller.
I can't see the capital planning.
I don't see the capital planning.
We're not going to sit here and reevaluate everything this committee did.
Right, but it just has to be in the works.
It has to be in the works.
But in my opinion, as a member of the capital planning committee, I can only speak as one member of seven, it's going to be a rubber stamp.
But it still has to go through the process.
Right.
Yeah.
But I agree with you, but somebody's going to submit it.
Right.
Well,
Somebody submits it in the capital planning, which I'm on also.
Oh, that's right.
We're going to approve it.
We understand.
We already,
but somebody's going to submit it,
right,
which they did not this year.
Right.
Which would be ready for annual town meeting.
Right.
In FY19. If we didn't get awarded in February of FY18.
Right.
Yeah.
So
it would be ready to go at that point.
Okay. Right. So I think it does make sense to, if we all agree that if there's a chance we won't get awarded, we want the smaller facility. As a committee. I think the smaller facility needs to be reviewed by wastewater treatment facility to say what you really need in the highway department, what in can we eliminate, and what is essential for this to operate. And then we would ask them to take out what's not needed and resubmit.
I have no idea.
So here's the last question I got going on that theory. So should we be collectively, me and Keith, be inviting Chris in to start talking about this, to review what we got, see what we've got, see what we've got.
Well, I think you and
because they're the ones going to be doing the drawings, unless you got an idea.
I think you and Keith need to sit down and just look at the plan and say yes. This headwork portion I need. Do I need this empty bay? No.
Yeah. Everything else is. Yeah, it's all.
I think it's as simple as saying we eliminate half the building because it's an empty bay.
That's right. It really is. I mean, essentially, other than that, there is one little caveat there. Tony had put the power panels or the MCC for the headworks inside, on the inside wall of the truck bay, I believe.
Yeah.
So
we'd have to build a little outside explosion-proof building to put the power panel in.
Exactly, yeah. Bump it out a little bit on one side, right, and then separate it so that it's not exposed to.
That's why they're saying that they're willing to do it for nothing, because it's very minimal design.
Exactly. And really all it is, essentially, at that beyond that, is just the basic headworks, which is bar screen, mechanical bar screen, grit and grease removal, separation, roll-up door, and a little loading dock to bring the bin out to for, like, waste management to dump. And then the building to keep it warm and from freezing. That was it.
If that empty bay was not to hold the vac truck, would it be used for any additional future equipment? Is that, was that one of the thought processes?
Feasibly, we could be bringing down a sewer reamer, which is now housed in.
No, not that type of equipment. I'm talking about operational equipment for the wastewater treatment plant. I mean, you were talking about.
The space itself, if you were to reconfigure and leave that same space available for something else?
Yes.
There perhaps is, it would be.
Well, my thought is that the building be designed so it could be added to.
Actually, the space that would create, perhaps, if you were to snug the headworks up to the existing building closer, instead of having that vac truck bay in between and the headworks, if you bumped it over here, now you're talking about leaving that whole area where the current carport is and the spare aerators and that whole plateau where it used to be a sludge drying bed.
For future.
That actually might be able to accommodate a.
Clarifier.
Exactly. Thank you. I was hoping you'd see. You know. That's exactly what I was thinking. An additional clarifier without having to risk one at the close to
the. Close to the bank, it's going to be in the river in a couple
of years. That's. I'm very trepidatious about doing that, but, you know, whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you think? What do you think we should do?
Yeah.
I think it's something to seriously consider.
So if we were to, I don't think the committee can discuss this with Weston Sampson. I think it needs to be either the highway department or the sewer commissioners. But I'm not sure we have the authority. We have the authority to actually request funds and spend funds, but we have to go through the sewer commissioners.
Well, we don't have the authority to make any decision on reality. I mean,
it would be nice
to be part of it so that in the future, if there's any of the members on there, it wouldn't be like we are sitting with no history or anything else. Mm-hmm. So that you would be, you know, but not as far as making a determination, that's not part of what we do.
We're supposed to make a recommendation.
So a recommendation to
the sewer commissioners. The sewer commissioners. In conference with
the select Keith and right Kevin. Here, select board, capital improvements planning committee, planning board, conservation commission, town administrator, and town clerk.
What?
That's.
We're just supposed to make a recommendation.
That's
to
all.
Right. No, I know.
That's our.
Right. So, we would recommend to the sewer commissioners that they continue with Weston Sampson.
Doesn't say sewer commission.
Huh?
Doesn't say sewer commission.
Selectman?
I mean, maybe we should. Maybe it should say that.
What is it? Who do we make the recommendation to?
Select board, capital improvements planning committee, planning board, conservation commission, town administrator, and town clerk. Probably should say the sewer
commission.
Well,
the because the sewer
are the select board.
Right.
yeah. So
are the sewer commissioners.
Because I think that could start the ball rolling, and then the select board would bring Keith and Kevin in to work with Weston Sampson. They could actually come to our meeting, and once they get started, actually at that point, we, you know, if that's the route we're going, we don't need to hear anymore from Weston.
Well, I think should anyone, that's personal opinion, but you guys have asked.
I think when I make a presentation,
right?
Yes, definitely. I think it should be a public presentation to the board and to any residents in town that want to come about what we're going to do. If we don't get the headworks, we're going to ask you people to fund it. And we might, the sewer commissioners might be asking them for a short-term solution. What do you think, Kevin?
I think it'll cost $3,800 for each user. That's okay. I don't use it.
A year?
For what? $1 million?
For $2.5 million.
For 40 years?
No, just if it was a one-time thing.
One-time, $3,800?
Yeah.
I'll pay that, because I'm a user, I have no issues with that.
But it's not gonna be a one-time thing, it's gonna be over 40...
30 years.
Well, either 30 or 40-year grant loan. 25% loan, 75%, I mean, 75% loan, 25% grant. You can go four, it's...
It's $40,000 per million.
$1,000 per million, right. $40,000 per million per year.
So...
Last year, we, well, it doesn't really have a lot to do with it, but it kinda does. Last year, when we changed the rates, we anticipated being able to put some money aside to do this.
Yep.
And the sewer budget went up, all the money that we put aside.
It has a lot of money in it for planning.
What's that?
Design. It has money in it for design and planning.
In the sewer budget?
Yes.
Correct.
It's still there, correct?
$100,000.
Plus FY18, the money's there in there.
I'm saying, there's money in there for 17 already, but there's money in there for already, for eight, additional funds for 18. And most of it is because of the INI report that has to be submitted in December. Which we don't even, we're not part of.
Right.
The sewer commissioners are.
Yes.
And the highway department is.
Yes.
And so that, they needed that money to pay for that, whatever they're gonna do.
And obviously, whatever monies are not used for that, basically go back into the general revenue of...
It stays with the sewer.
Stays there.
I mean, that, if we could get the headworks off our plate, we could then look to the two plants. That would be my feeling. And then we could hire an engineer to do the study that they, that was either a priority task to determine how we're going to deal with Old Deerfield and South Deerfield. Come up, they're gonna evaluate all the options, come up with dollars and cents, and say, this is your option A, B, C, and D. This is what it's gonna cost you to do each one of them.
So
that was $100,000, as I recall.
To do that?
Yep.
Okay, so I found, going back to what I was asking you. So remember back when, does anybody want to consider this? Remember back when I tried to get Dr. Kostecki to join our committee?
Yeah.
He said he was too busy. He said to me, he was the provost of the University of Massachusetts, a professor of environmental engineering. And he said that the engineering department at UMass is always looking for real-world projects. Okay? And he said that I should contact him if we wanted him to contact the Department of Engineering. And I just happen to know another professor at the environment, who's a guy named Douglas Borgatti, who bought a car from me. It turns out he's the operations director for the Springfield Water and Sewer Commission, and he's now a professor in the Department of Environmental Engineering at UMass. So,
what was his name?
His name is Doug Borgatti.
Oh, I know exactly who that is. He has given lectures at MWPCA training sessions. And I happened to, in fact, the last time I saw him, he gave me an idea that I implemented at both plants about keeping zero blankets in the final clarifiers. And he has a PhD.
And he told me, I was on a demo ride with him, and he told me what he did for a living, and he told me that he loved sewage treatment plants. He was fascinated by it, and it was his passion.
Yep.
Okay, and I never...
No, he's really quite a guy.
He's
sharp.
He's a pretty interesting guy.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I don't know if, I don't know. I can make a phone call or two.
Yeah, I would.
And see if...
Yep.
If they can help us. And maybe they could save us.
What does he do with that Springfield Water and Sewer?
He used to.
Oh, used to.
Retired. I think that's what you said.
No. Well, this says, and I've just been Googling, it says that he's a well-known professional in the wastewater treatment industry, mm-hmm. and he works as operations director for Springfield Water and Sewer.
Yep.
But he also worked for...
I thought it was UMass.
He also was associated with the New England Water Environment and Association,
mm-hmm.
which I think is in Lowell, maybe?
NUWEA, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
See, there's another one.
And it says now that he's going to be a professor of environmental engineering at UMass.
It's not like he's either going to be full-time professor or part-time.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sure that Josh knows him because Josh is the executive director
right.
down there. So, I have.
So, I can call Paul Kostecki tomorrow and ask him if he can help
sure.
us, if everyone agrees.
Right. Any help we can get is good.
So what do we want him to think? We have, if we say the headworks is moving forward, we're not going to ask somebody to recreate that wheel.
No, we could ask them to just look at it.
Okay.
That's,
mm-hmm.
Be like
that's
a peer
what
review.
Bob was
yep.
suggesting.
Okay.
We could ask them to look at it and then look at
The rest of the
right. plans and the rest of the...
We don't have any other plans.
Or the rest
thoughts.
Of the...
I do.
The rest of the problems.
Right. So mm-hmm. the next step would be for somebody to do an evaluation of both sewage treatment plants, determine what's needed,
mm-hmm.
whether we needed to eliminate one or bring them both up to code, and how we might do that. That's what...
It's already been done, though.
No, it hasn't.
Wesson and Sampson did.
No, they didn't.
Well,
they talked the story.
Pardon?
They never did the work. They talked the story.
Where did they get their amounts from? The numbers, the dollars?
They said we have cost $8,000 to do 100 linear feet of force main.
I can't what?
It cost $8,000 to do 100 linear feet of force main. So they multiplied the distance between X and Y. That's how they come up with the dollars.
They have like algorithms that they use to
there was no
to spec out
the standard formula.
Right. The
right.
standard formula, right.
Somebody asked me how much do you think it's gonna cost to buy a used Toyota 2015, it's gonna be X amount of dollars average.
Yeah, on average, yeah. And it could be less if you buy a junky one, and it could be more if you buy a real nice one. And it can be.
And that's all Wesson and Sampson did.
And yeah. and that's why I think that when Wesson and Sampson said it would cost $10 million to run a force main to Greenfield, they were just using that formula. And the formula, mm-hmm. how many times do you run a force main just through a cornfield? Never. So, But I think our first, I think this is, we're on a good track here to make this first recommendation to the select board, the CIPC, et cetera, which is we recommend that we have Wesson and Sampson downsize. I think I'm making a motion.
I'm writing it down.
This is a motion. We recommend that Wesson and Sampson downsize the headworks project to, what are we saying? I don't know what the number is. One
to the original idea?
To the original project. Right.
Yes.
To the original project.
Yeah.
And reapply for the Mass Works grant. And then if the Mass Works grant doesn't come through, we recommend that we use our own revenue to build it.
Right. And appropriate.
I'll second that.
And then that, in consultation with the, what's your titles?
Chief Operator.
Chief Operator and...
Highway Superintendent.
And Sewer Commissioners.
I have a question.
And at the same time as, when they look to downsize that, as you mentioned before, Keith, bringing that up towards the original building, so it leaves you more room...
Yes.
For future.
Yes.
If we keep that in mind.
Yeah.
I think that conversation can be made between, I think we should add the Highway Department and the Sewer Commissioners.
Well, I thought his title is the Highway Department.
I mean, Highway Superintendent.
DPW Superintendent, so technically I'm the department head for that too, so.
Yeah. Does this cover, like Keith mentioned earlier, if we wait 2 or 3 years and build something that's really good, it'll take care of the nitrogen and all the other stuff that's gonna have to be done in the future?
Well, you'll be prepared for that.
Be prepared for that with this?
Yes.
That's what I was kinda getting at with the size of the building. Is it big enough to add that?
Depends on how...
Well, we don't know.
Yeah.
So it's an addition.
Once again, we're speculating at this point.
Yeah.
One of the things that we have to keep in mind is that whatever size this building is, then the original plans, although the plan was for the building, there was also the process of the property next door and that cost associated with that, if it was available and whatever.
It's in another town.
No, no, you mean the house.
The house next door.
In front of the plant.
Oh, in front of it.
Because you can't, we can't go the other direction.
Right, that's what I was thinking, you couldn't go to it.
Right, because that's all in 61.
That's one thing that I know that the Board of Selectmen were real concerned about before, was, you know, taking that property.
For what purpose?
It was in the way, you couldn't put up that building, you couldn't go through with the headworks project without that. There was not enough land.
We designed a project on somebody else's property?
He was gonna have a new office building.
Why do you think I said no?
Where the house is now, and then have the new plant start from there and go out. Is that right? That's what I remember.
Yeah, it was basically, it was coming into 150 feet roughly onto her property. So there was multiple...
So the existing headworks building that we paid for was partly designed on private property with...
The large one, correct. Now, going off of the small one, they can probably go ahead and change that up.
Yeah.
You know, use that existing wall of the existing building now, so, and then run off from there. I'm assuming, I don't know.
And the property line for our plant, the town's plant, actually extends past the existing fence to where the edge of the trees end. All those trees there on her side of the fence also really belong to us.
So it needs, so, well, I think it needs, like, it needs to be on private, town property.
Yeah.
And that's something that...
I don't see a problem with that now.
I think maybe the Weston Sampson would have to meet, like you suggested with you guys, if you had authorization from this select board, and discuss the issues that, you know, that we have. I don't think we can come if we'd like, but I don't think we need to be part of the process.
I don't think we need to be part of the process, but it might not hurt to attend and listen, as Bruce mentioned earlier. You know, just for the history, and if we're involved down the road, instead of starting new and not having all the facts.
Yeah.
That's been part of the problem here.
Yeah.
You know, so...
I mean, I think starting with something like the headworks and new generator, that's fantastic. And then perhaps in the process of that becoming reality, if it does, it would be prudent, while we have Weston and Sampson's ear and talents, to explore other things for the future, and at least have an idea of what we're gonna need to do down the road as maybe a phase 2, phase 3 kind of scenario. And then ultimately decide whether or not Old Deerfield's gonna remain viable as a treatment plant, or if it's gonna change in some way.
I think that's what we're talking about, maybe having...
Those engineers.
Jack's connections there.
Jack's connections.
That would be fantastic.
Give us an evaluation.
Yeah.
And then we can make another recommendation from his to go to the next step. And then the select board would be authorize the next phase.
Those are really good contacts too, that you have, that you came up with. Fantastic.
Hope his car's doing well.
Well, I haven't heard from him, so.
Yeah.
Did he buy the car?
Did he buy from Pleasant Journey?
Yeah.
Nice.
So we have a motion on the table.
Second by Bruce.
Second by Bruce with addition in consultation. Consultation with wastewater treatment plant operator Highbury, DPW superintendent and select and the sewer commissioners.
Any more comments?
Any more comment?
What was the rest, what's the whole motion? Because I was out of the room.
Motion is to request Weston Sampson to downsize the existing headworks project to its, the original project proposed. And prepare an application to the Mass Works program for October 2017, at no additional fee. And that would be in consultation, the downsizing will be in consultation with wastewater treatment plant operator, highway, DPW superintendent, and the sewer commissioners.
But the decision would be the Board of Selectmen, sewer commissioners.
Yes, we're making the recommendation.
Yeah.
That they do this. We're recommending that they request Weston Sampson to.
Just hope that Weston Sampson doesn't throw out the other for later reference. If you want to go with a bigger project down the road, we'd want to start from scratch on some of that stuff.
The only thing, as far as I see, we're eliminating is the bay for the vac truck.
All right, that's fine.
And we're building a little building for the power supply.
And inadvertently leaving yourself room for a secondary clarifier, just not quite so much of the.
I just want, don't want to throw out.
I don't know, I agree 100%, but I don't know what we're throwing out.
I just want to make sure that we're not turning anything.
Well, I think with the review by the professor at UMass, we'll say, yeah, this is just what you need, and you might want to think about adding this, or maybe make some comment.
So.
But we're not the people that can say, yes, right, we're throwing the baby out with the bathwater.
I'm satisfied.
Well, hearing no further comments, all those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstain? It's unanimous, I guess.
Okay. I'll prepare it.
I have a question. Do you know where the property lines are specifically down there? Have they been, the pins are all there and?
Some of the pins are there. When Weston and Sampson came up with the original layout for a whole plant upgrade, including an additional secondary clarifier near the river, it was discovered where, how much they would need to bump out if they could into the potato field. But yes, the existing property lines are well known.
But is there any land between there and the potato field that isn't being used by us right now?
No.
Okay.
No. There's a slope, very tiny slope, and then there's the fence.
Okay.
And then the potato field.
Well, years ago when the other plant was there, right, before the 70s,
uh-huh,
right, they owned land out there that was being cultivated in potatoes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Kind of like old Deerfield, I know, actually owns more of the cornfield. They let the farmer utilize it anyway.
That was one reason I asked the question.
Yeah, well, with Captain Lathrop pump station, Kip has found, you were here for that discussion?
Yes.
Kevin wasn't.
Kevin wasn't.
I was there.
John.
You were?
Well, he was there when we...
Oh, you were there?
Yeah, he was there.
So you think that's a good possibility?
I think that's a viable plan. I'll be honest with you, something was just actually dropped on my desk today that I haven't really looked at too much, but basically it's the same general idea, but all of the controls and everything is, nothing is in the water. The pumps are not in the water, the controls are not in the water. Everything is self-contained, basically sits on top of your existing tank or your pit. And the guy ballparked it out. He says, we should be able to put this in for about 50 grand. And I was like, can I hold you to that? He's like, well, no. I was like, well, then don't throw out numbers if you don't know. I said, you haven't even seen it.
So between you guys, you've come up with some options to at least extend the life of Captain Lathrop Pump Station.
I know that John still, I don't believe that he sent you any information on those pumps, has he? No.
No, but I got a pretty good idea of the pumps that he's talking about. Those are the...
I sent you a video, I think, of one of them. Yeah, the grinder pump.
Starts with a T. Anyway, I understand. I know what the pumps he's talking about.
Kevin, that person that provided that information today, is he going to follow up and take a look at that with you?
Be honest with you, I was running out the door, and I was like, grab my card. Here it is. I'll look at your stuff, and we'll talk next week.
Okay.
Basically how he left it.
Oh, is that the guy?
That was the guy you sent up.
Okay. Doug Reed, I think his name is.
Yep.
Doug Reynolds or something.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah.
So there's a few options here that they'll look at for the Captain Lathrop issue.
A step back.
Yeah.
Your comment, Kevin wasn't here when you were talking about Pritchard, and he spoke.
Yes, I was going to bring that back up.
Oh, okay.
Because that is the next item on the agenda.
Oh, I didn't have a copy of
that. David Prickett responded to the questions that we had a couple weeks ago. He sent a follow-up email, it said, I'll pass it out, but so you'll all have a copy, but I'll read. No, I need to keep one. It says, have you received any input from the South County Sewer Study Committee Chair? If possible, I would like to meet with you, Kip and Kevin, and go through the recently authorized INI and remaining INI compliance tasks and sewer rate study updates, if possible. I prepared a lengthy response, send it to Kip. We decided not to send it, which you have is the second page. Our response, at least to the rate study, was, as per the rate study, Kip and I have discussed your last email. Our feeling is until the sewer study committee has completed its work relative to capital improvement requirements, there is no need to meet relative to the rate study. Furthermore, we feel that the contract requirement for a final memorandum should be discussed with the persons last committee you worked with that established the basis for the study, not the sewer study committee. Kip may be able to meet with you and Kevin, but he agreed that I should meet with you also to go forward and authorize with the discussion of the INI tasks and remaining compliance tasks. The sewer study committee interest in this issue is what is required for the INI reporting and how it will affect the capital improvement plan and budget. So we really feel that it's up to Kevin, and if Kip wants to go, I'll be glad to go and meet relative to the INI reporting. Just to see, and they can come to the committee. and discuss it, but really is not our responsibility, I don't think, to review a report that is due to the state as part of a standard reporting. We don't need to have that discussion.
It's an operation.
If, what we need to know is that how it will affect the sewer budget potentially, maybe, and how it might affect our capital improvement plan. If they're saying that we've got to replace 5,000 feet of sewer main, it might affect our capital plan. But if it doesn't, I think it's something that can be handled without this committee. And again, the rate study, I think that they've been paid in full, in my opinion, have not completed the contract. They did not do a public presentation. They have not submitted a final memorandum of their findings. Both of those things should be done. I think they're willing to do the final memorandum once they have an agreement by somebody, not this committee, that the study is what they wanted it to do. So this committee was not involved in the study.
Kevin, was that yourself and Doug?
Doug, that is correct. Yeah. So basically what we did is part of the original sewer study, or is part of the original rate study, because you have to step back, you have to figure out what's broke, what are you gonna fix, and how much it's gonna cost. Once you get A, B, and C, that'll tell you what the rate study is. But if you don't know what your capital is, then once again, you're going back to speculating. So if you don't, and they were going off of the original plans, of that is why that 20-year plan that they put together,
yep, mm-hmm,
was based on that original. So if we change that down smaller, which inadvertently will change up the rate, because you're not looking at spending 20 million.
And that's the reason that I responded back that we're not in a position to make any further suggestions until we complete our report.
Right.
So I think that the project should be closed out with the knowledge of what you did, was an estimate of the capital improvements. There were no hard figures. And this is what it potentially could be. And they should issue a final memorandum for the select board so it can be mailed to the residents of the town that run the sewer system.
To include a presentation?
I don't think you're gonna get it out of it. Okay. How much have you got on the INI report?
Jimmy?
How much have they done on the INI already?
James, one of his assistants, came in and took a boatload of information from Keith, mm-hmm, yesterday, day before
yesterday.
A couple days ago.
Yep.
So that is the last piece that he needed.
So he got the stuff out of the office?
Yes, because they had already come in and they've already grabbed all that information. So what he's trying to do is, once again, he's just trying to take everything that we've done in the past and then go to DEP and say,
that was our, that's what we asked?
Yeah. Correct. Okay. Correct. So and that's what he originally wanted to do back in November. But because we didn't make the decision officially until February, that's why we missed the flow. So worst case scenario is we go to DEP collectively and say, this is what we've done, this is where we're at, what more do you want? Now, if they say, well, we want more flows, all it'll be is it'll be done underneath a consent order.
Yeah.
Which is basically would be next spring.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So, but as long as we can go to them ahead of time before the 11th hour of the INI report and say, you know, this is where we're at, we weren't able to do this, they're going to cut you a little slack. But if we wait right to the bitter end, then they're going to look at you and say, you know, well, you've been dragging your feet all year, so
what should we do? 2 years.
I'm sorry? Yeah, exactly.
Okay. That's all. I was just curious on an update. It really doesn't affect the committee unless we have, unless DEP, after they review the report, come back and say, because what they're going to do is review the reports, then they're going to make recommendations to the towns for what they need to do. Part of that, we would like to know what the recommendation is to include it in our capital improvement.
Oh, certainly. You know, I'm quite sure that, you know, they're probably going to, because we, they did go through at one point in time, and I can't remember exactly when it was, because it was before I even came to work for the town. They went through, they did the smoke test, you know, they did all of that. They're just trying to figure out if all of those things they've done in the past is going to give us some credits. You know, the theory of doing the manhole inspections, you know.
Yeah, we did 500 manhole inspections, 538. And all that was handed out to every committee member, the third meeting we had. So any of that information, if we knew we had to do this report by December, I don't think that we held up anything, to be honest with you.
Well, no, like I said, it was the request that I put in, requesting to spend the $3,000 for him to go ahead and put it all together. That was put together in November, and the decision was not made until February.
Do you have a dollar amount that's going to, he's going to charge us to prepare the report?
To prepare the report?
Yeah. Well, are you going to write it?
I doubt I'm going to write it, because I probably won't do it right, to be honest with you. I mean, it's not.
You might want to get that and see what it's going to be so you can.
Right. But at least we know, we need, like I said, he's going to take everything together for the $3,000. He's taking everything together and bringing it to them and saying, here you go. Because you can't really fill out the report if you don't know what you're going to do, correct? I mean.
No, you can fill out the report and say, this is what we've done, and these are the dates we've done it. Then
correct.
We're going to come back to you and say, well, you need to do more smoke testing, or you need
correct.
To do more of that.
So you can't fill out the report until you know what they're going to be asking, which inadvertently,
whatever.
We'll play the scenario out of he goes ahead, he takes everything, puts it together, hands it to them, DEP says, I want you to do more manhole, I want some sewer line cambered, and I want more smoke tests. So that at that point in time, then we can go ahead and we can put that, do that, and then all of that will be put into the final report.
And the reason we're doing that is because we haven't done anything since early 1990s.
Okay.
And if we had continued to do the maintenance and do the smoke testing and do the flow testing that you normally would do.
That should have been done all along.
It should have been done all along.
Right.
That report could have been submitted just without going to DEP.
Probably.
So I think it's the best track that we're on.
Mm-hmm.
But DEP's going to say, you might have to do this, you know, and you're not going to be able to do it.
Right.
But
you mean like do a flow. So the flow would be, you would have to wait until the next flow season, which would be next spring.
Right, and that's going to be critical. Interconnections that might allow you to do now.
Right.
So, but, okay, until he gets DEP, he won't know what the final price is going to be.
Exactly, because we won't know what they want.
Okay. So,
correct me if I'm wrong.
You guys, you and Wendy can probably, or you can just let David Pritchett know that he can do the final memorandum.
Sure.
And I know there's money in his budget, or at least in the capital improvement portion, for an update every year. It was $2,000 to update the report every year. So,
which report? I'm sorry.
The rate study report.
Okay.
But again, what was budgeted in his study was a $2,000 annual update.
Correct.
$2,000 annual update.
Correct. Going on the theory of the original plan.
Yes.
Has the town agreed to that? To spend the $2,000?
No. They haven't agreed to do anything.
No, because everything was just laid out, and no.
Right.
Hard decisions that are made.
Right now, we're continuing with the option that is in the report. Mm-hmm. We've modified some of the numbers, but that was what our recommendation was.
The methodology.
Even before the report came out. So nothing has changed, other than we have made some other, we've had some other discussion on options that we could bring to the update. But I think you have to finalize the report, get it to the sewer users in town so they know what, why, what they might anticipate. Then we might get some people in, coming into this meeting and saying, well, we think we should do this, we think we should do that.
Right. So, you're gonna have to bear with me here, because I'm just trying to make sure that I got my mind wrapped around this, make sure I'm asking him the correct thing. So with him doing the final memorandum, if he did it right now, is going off of the original plan?
The draft, whatever he submitted.
The original draft plan, which was what Weston and Sampson drew up. My understanding.
$20 million or $30 million?
The rate study that was done by David Pritchett included whatever Weston and Sampson came up with for capital improvement.
That's correct. So if we're changing
With that, because that's all we had, and we still don't have anything different.
Right, okay.
I'm not gonna modify one number when we don't, we still don't know what it is. Or increase the headworks program from 1.5 to 3.4.
Right.
Which would then just increase the numbers. That doesn't make any sense.
Correct.
We haven't finished our evaluation yet, so we can't give him new numbers. He needs a finalized report and send it out to the sewer users, making, and the statement letter should be, these are numbers were looked at as an estimate.
Right.
Nothing has been finalized.
I disagree with that.
Okay.
I think you're gonna send something out based on $20 or $30 million that they used. It was like we earlier said, they kind of picked a number out of the air based on some algorithm. You're gonna get sewer users, they're gonna be panicking for some number that came out of thin air.
Okay, well then the sewer commissioners, decide what to do with it.
This whole thing is like, it doesn't matter really how, what the total number is. It's how are we going to set the rate? That's the issue, because
the rate's going to change every year.
It is.
How can you set the rate if you don't know what you got to buy? That's what I don't understand. This is the part I'm not grasping.
That's what I'm saying. If the rate is one thing, but how you come up with how you're going to do it. In other words, are we going to continue on by the gallons used? Are we going to set a separate fee for our capital improvements? Are we going to set a meter fee? Of course, the dollar amount is definitely going to change the rate number, but it's how do we...
We know how much the number is going to be, but how are we going to get there?
I understand. Thank you.
Regardless, the bottom line is, if whatever we do is $1 million, you divide it by 880. If it's 2 million, you divide it by 880. If it's 10 million, you divide it by 880. And how you get that number, do you want to charge people by per the gallon or per gallon and change the rate? Do you want to charge them by bedrooms? I mean, there's all of those things that we already spoke about.
Understood.
Yeah.
So you're looking at the style of rate.
Exactly.
Yeah. The methodology of
the reason,
rate.
The reason that David Pritchett
it seems like it's going to be fair, that people are going to feel is fair and equitable for every user, regardless of whether they're minimum users or whether they're big users.
And part of the thought process going back is that, you know, we had thought about how to set this rate, but we didn't want to create everybody to be more conservative and then try to use less water, because that was going to create another problem for us. So that's why we set that a bar, if you will, or whatever, that $100 fee, and I think the number was you got up to 8,000 gallons that you could use before you'd be charged more. But yet those were the people that complained the loudest, because they said, look, I only use 4,000 gallons. So now if you divide that out, you know, the guy down the street that uses 10,000, he's paying $9 per thousand, but I'm paying $20 per thousand, you know, so.
So let me just get back to the rates.
That's it. So we have plenty of arguing to do about that.
Arguing
to do about that.
So the intent of the rate study was, the way I see that it was prepared, was to have X amount of dollars for capital improvements. We had no idea what they were going to be, so they picked it out of the air. David Pritchett came up and took that amount of money, ran it through using the option that was chosen by how the rates were being charged.
What option was that?
Same rate, same way we're doing it. There was other options proposed. They agreed not to use those.
Okay.
In his study, he states that needs to be annually updated to account for known costs. Now, once you know a cost of a capital improvement, now you can change the rate study and reproject the numbers.
Well, that's what we do anyways.
But you don't change the numbers until you actually borrow the money. That's the way the study is established. You don't borrow it in advance.
No, okay. I get that. But what the town has traditionally done is just gone by what do we need to operate the plant.
Understood.
It didn't have that capital feature.
And so we're trying to build a little bit of capital reserves so that we can pay for the design to go forward or the studies to go forward into the next phases. Because without plans, you're not going to build a thing.
Right. So the cost of that INI was figured into this year's sewer budget? Is
correct.
That what you're saying?
You're correct. Going on the theory that in February, March, we would have been spending money putting meters in the manholes to check our flows, which we were not able to do.
How do you remember how that discussion went? Because I do remember when we chose the rate for the sewer, we were going to end up with about $80,000 that we could use for future expenditures. And after looking at the budget, it was like we just barely got enough. But I didn't realize that, and I don't believe that we took into consideration that INI study was going to be paid for. And we didn't anticipate that. We just went by all the fixed costs that were.
Were you in the meeting with the police department?
Yes.
That's when we discussed each of these issues, line item by line item, on why there was an increase, and we actually reduced some of the line items in that budget.
But that was this in 2017.
For the 18.
Right, but what I'm talking about is last October.
Well, we spent Captain Lathrop pump station? You said 90,000.
Yeah, and that was, again, going on the plan that was drawn for replacing or the upgrade.
No, what you spent in 17 is what Kip's talking about.
Right.
What I'm talking about is
we didn't spend the money because we didn't do anything to it.
Right, they didn't spend the money. What I'm talking about is the sewer commissioners. When
right,
we had, I think the figure was around $650,000, and that's what we ended up setting the rate of $9, and then we changed the minimum fee. So the net generated dollars was going to be about $730,000, which in fact that's what we did raise. But then I looked at this year's budget, I think it was $768,000. It was about that. And I was thinking to myself, how did we miss that? You know, but I didn't realize that the money for the INI was figured into the 2017 budget. But that money's not yet spent. So.
But that's also part and parcel of the problem with the billing of the sewer users, because you're setting the rate
behind
6 months after fiscal year,
right?
And rather than up front. I don't know what the correction could be, other than if you move the entire cycle back 6 months to pretty much fall in line with the regular town meeting kind of situation, because you're always, every year you're going to be behind the eight ball on that by doing it the way you're doing it right now. You have to change that billing cycle, the rate setting cycle, to the beginning of the year so that you're doing it for the future, such as the budget is, and not for the past.
Well, I have no problem bringing that up, and we can talk about that right after town meeting, and we can do that. I don't see why we can't.
You're the board of select commissioners. You have that right.
But I think...
Something needs to be addressed, I think.
But in the past, or not that much, but last year, this board didn't really have a recommendation other than to continue doing it as we did. So that's what we went, ran with. And if it doesn't change, if we don't come up with something different, you know, that's something that we definitely can, you know, talk about and set it sooner so we don't have to wait until the end.
Well, that's been part and parcel of the problem, not just, it's not a brand new problem. It's been a problem forever because they've always done it. They have never set the rates until October, November.
I don't see, I mean, it's not that big of a discussion. It's something that we can talk about and we can set it, you know.
The only thing is getting the compliance with the water departments, because that's what you're dependent on.
It's when they make the readings, they make the readings.
Yeah.
Mid-year.
Right, so you'd have to, you know, you'd have to sit down with, because that's a voluntary...
Well, they do, when do they do that? In the spring and fall?
Spring and fall.
So we could go off the spring, because that's the winter use, and that's primarily what they use anyways, because everybody gets that.
But you gotta be double up on the bills when you have to do that.
No. You just change the way you do it. Just say, here's what we forecast for the next year.
Oh, the forecasting, yeah. So you're not gonna...
Right.
Yeah, you're not gonna bill.
And it would be a lot more fair to all the other budgets, because, you know, when you're presenting the budgets to these other towns and so forth, what you presented them even this year is your rates based on last year. So they're all gonna come up short. Because that's all they had to use. So, you know, to, if you want everybody, including the town itself or the town buildings, to have an accurate number for their sewer users, you need to have that rate set prior to town meeting, in all reality.
Well, that won't happen this year, but...
No, it's not gonna happen this year. Things are happening way too fast.
So actually, what you need to do next year is set rates twice.
Twice?
No.
You only have to set rates once. When you make the decision in October, that goes back to July 1st, correct?
Right, and that's the problem.
That's the problem.
Right. So if you set it before July 1st, then me being a tax, me being a user, now I know what I'm being charged, because realistically, I don't know until 6 months later what I'm being charged for what I've already used.
But you get two bills.
Which really isn't fair to a user.
You get two bills. You get one in spring, one in the fall.
Correct.
So your April reading is for your winter bill.
Yep.
So if we were to set your rate going forward off of that rate, you'd have to multiply by the user summer rate calculation.
But there again, the problem being is you don't have that rate out for budget setting.
Right, too late. So you have to use the October rate to look forward 9 months.
Right.
That's where I think the issue is.
So, well, yeah, right, and there again.
Because we rely on October and March or April readings, and we can't change those.
Right.
So when we get our October readings, we must be getting readings now to set rates.
Yeah, they're out, well, actually, they're out now, still collecting.
Well, somehow it really needs to be addressed.
In Greenfield, they do.
And that's not our target. That's not our discussion, but that's something that's been a problem for years.
Right.
Okay.
I know in Greenfield, they do July, January for billing.
They could talk to the water commissioner.
That's what I'm saying, if we change the billing, there's gonna be a period where we're gonna be overlapping bills.
Yeah.
They could play catch-up.
Somebody could ask the water commissioners if they wanted to change the reading, so they read the 1st of July.
There you go.
And January 1st.
That's how
their whole system works.
Why are we changing the reading? Now we're just talking at the rate per gallon we're gonna change.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And use a prospective rate.
You're gonna use
to compute the rate per gallon.
A 9-month-old rate to compute it going forward.
Yeah.
We're billing
history rather than future.
But I've...
Right now it's 6 months.
Compute the amount per gallon.
Yeah.
Right, but all of the water usage that I've looked at, they really are consistent. I mean, there are isolated instances that different things happen.
And I think it's a non-issue.
Yeah.
Let's just go forward.
Yep.
So next item was management areas. Any more discussion on those?
Well, it seemed like we needed legal advice.
We do. The select board can do that. So, you know, it's something that, you know, we haven't spoken to a great deal of length about, but...
I understand because of the budget season.
But that's something that, you know, we have spoke about and...
Well, we haven't talked to Kevin or Keith about it, but we're looking, the selectmen are gonna be asking to start keeping track of expenses.
They were asked last meeting.
Kevin's done it.
Him and I got together.
He did.
And went through all of fiscal year 17 and figured out which belonged to which plant.
Oh, you did, great.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, we did.
Great.
Last week or earlier this week? I think it was last week we did that.
6 hours worth of photocopying.
Yeah, there it is.
3 hours worth of the E&I together.
Yeah.
Good job, excellent. So nobody had to ask you to do it.
Thank you.
So it's separated by...
Yeah.
By sewer line maintenance, Captain Lathrop, lift station, Old Deerfield, South Deerfield. Now, it hasn't been broken down yet by line item to be able to give me my numbers per line item.
Yeah.
We haven't gotten that far yet.
But you've collected all the data.
That's correct.
Somebody needs to put it in a spreadsheet.
So this is up to the last warrant, right there.
Somebody needs to put it in a spreadsheet, right?
Yep. Want to do that?
I don't know.
Can we like hire a high school...
Spreadsheet masters right there.
Like hire a high school kid or something?
We could hire some of your masters to do that for us.
I was gonna say, we could try to get a... Where's that crew? That's part and parcel of engineering.
Exactly.
Yeah, we could get an internship.
Yeah, we could try to get an internship.
It's creating studies, so that's part and parcel.
Can Brenda download that, her records to Excel?
That I do not know.
Well, if she can download it to Excel, it's just a matter of adding two or three columns or those, the breakdown for your five or six different things. And it shouldn't take that...
Oh, I understand what you're saying. You're taking each of the line item on a spreadsheet.
Yeah.
And then adding, so this one is South Deerfield, this one's Old Deerfield.
You take that, the invoice that she paid, if you get it onto a spreadsheet, you know, it's gonna say how much she paid, right? And then you have the breakdown as to what Old Deerfield and South Deerfield. You just post it over in that column.
Yep.
And it shouldn't take that long if you can get the Excel spreadsheet. If she can download it to Excel, okay? If she can't download it to Excel, she's probably got a similar program that she can get to.
Realistically, there's only, what, 22 items on the, I mean, I can make it.
22 items?
There's only 22line items, roughly.
22 items isn't gonna take you very long.
Exactly. Let's make sure we know.
So, but I'll ask, I mean, because if she can just boom, 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 then...
Did you figure out what to do with the stuff that belongs, that is bought for both, but is stored at South? And then Old Deerfield takes some of it as needed? And that's the part that's gotten kind of confusing.
That's gonna have to be done by percentage or something, by flow or something.
Oh, yeah, prorated.
Prorated by flow.
It's not gonna be an exact science.
Right.
No, no.
It'll be pretty close, though.
It'll be close, but it will not be 100%.
So do you need a UMass student to do this, do you think?
We could talk to Brenda first.
I'd go talk to Brenda first.
See if she can do a download.
Okay. And then if not, we can try to see if we can get...
I don't think it's a great big job, Bruce. If you got 22 invoices, if you got 22 different invoices to list down, you know...
22 line items, right.
It's a...
Categories.
No, it's more than 22 invoices.
It's 22 categories.
22 categories?
Yeah.
Categories.
How many invoices?
We care about categories and then...
And then each one of these...
We only care about the total.
Each one of these goes into a category.
Well, yes, no, I think...
How many invoices are we talking about? Just that pile?
This right here so far, minus the last warrant.
All right, so...
What's that, that's a year's worth?
No, this is...
Up to the last warrant.
This is...
So it's already on this.
This is...
9 months? That's good, that works.
This is FY 17, right here.
FY 18 or, we're in 18 right now.
And we have to account for the chemicals somehow.
Finishing up some...
Take that, I'm wrong.
This is FY 17.
All right, so you got 9 months in it.
Roughly.
Yeah.
Good.
All right.
So you want by line item? They can do that.
But I would have to, and then that way it'll give me a pretty good idea on what goes where.
One column is what account it is, and then you post it. And then you can sort by account.
Some of the expenditures...
I'm willing to sit with Brenda, if you wanna give me those, and see if she can do a download. Okay, and then if there's a manual, if we have to go manually from there, maybe I don't want to sit there and keep on shovels, but...
No, I understand.
But once you get the download...
If it's manual, we can get a UMass student.
You get a little 10-key...
Let me take a look.
Can I ask what download you're referring to?
Her checkbook.
Ah, okay.
Her county records.
Ah.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
Because that's how you pull the data from, right?
What I did was I pulled each warrant and copied every single one.
Yep.
And then Keith and I sat down and said, South Deerfield, Old Deerfield, wastewater, or lift station, sewer.
Yep.
And we just, we put them in piles, is what we did.
Is that, do they sort those sorted by plant?
Correct.
Those are sorted by plant.
The only other issue we ran into was last, just earlier this fiscal year, there were some expenses that were not bread and butter. They were long-term capital improvements, like new mag meter at Old Deerfield, a flow meter. Those are going to last for years and years and years.
Right.
So it's not an ordinary expense. It's extraordinary.
There is going to be a capital line item that's going to be unknown for each of the two plants.
Oh, you do it by plant. That's another category. Chemicals, capital items, by plant.
Yeah, not that hard.
I'll take the ball. I'll take the ball.
Great, thank you.
Temporarily. See what, I'll meet with Brenda.
Thank you. And you just took a load off my desk. Hey, John?
Remember that?
I was just going to say, yes, I will.
Do you have a 10-key?
And I'll bring another one to go along.
It's amazing how much progress we're making tonight.
Or you have to use the keyboard?
No.
Well, we like it or not.
It's like, got another, so...
We already discussed the funding options for the Mass Headworks.
Yes.
And the design replacement for the Captain Lathrop. And we also talked about the engineering study.
Yes.
So, that doesn't leave us with anything else to talk about, do you believe it?
I use the other ones, a lot easier.
Are you still going to have the two Johns come in?
I don't know.
I'm just asking, because is it worth it that now, or do you...
I've learned a lot from them, and they seem like they'd like to, but every time I, they say, yeah, sure, I tell them when the next meeting is, and I call them the day before, and oh, my son broke his arm, he's going to physical therapy, my wife's got a hair appointment, you know.
I think...
It's hard when you're asking people to do favors and they work...
I think with a UMass professor that might come in and do some...
If we can make some progress with that, hopefully.
I think that, and if any of us are interested in going to, you know, get, finding out where these bar screen designs are, going to them, right? Personally, I think we're just getting too many people involved from the outside, and all it's doing is creating more and more questions amongst all of us. We have to stop bringing in people from all over the world and start concentrating on narrowing this down.
Yeah, I think we did a good job of that tonight.
I think we did too. And I don't think, you know, I appreciate your offer, totally.
Yep, me too.
But I think it's just going to be one more step that gets muddled again.
Well, I don't want to do that, Bruce, but it's like,
you know,
John, they're all named John, you know, going to look at that station over there, I thought was really beneficial, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying it, but...
So I think that's something that is beneficial because it helps you guys make an improvement with we don't have to discuss.
Right, exactly. You know, and that's this other guy that I don't really know, who Josh, that lives up on Hillside Road, you know, I'm going to meet with him and his engineer just to talk about things in general. And, you know.
That's fair.
And I think there again, that's a sewer commissioner responsibility.
Yeah, I agree.
That's part and parcel of why these meetings have gone on for forever, is we have gotten involved, we've strayed off our charge and gotten into sewer commissioners' things too many times. And so I think that's why we've been spinning our wheels too much.
But
one thing that I'll say it again is that, you know, I've become more educated on this, and when people ask me questions, I don't just have to shrug my shoulders so often. You know, I can answer them.
We all have.
So
we didn't realize how steep the learning curve was going to be when we first met.
And there are so many choices and
so many choices
ways,
and so many issues. Right. And I know my thinking on certain topics has really changed from back a year ago.
Yep.
And
mine have too. It's been an eye-opener, but now it's time to move on. I mean, it's...
Right.
We only have a few more months and we're done.
Yep. Are you going to invite that fellow that runs the Springfield plant?
He lives right here.
Yeah, but...
Deerfield.
We're going to invite him to be part of the committee. He has to be part of the committee.
Yeah, his input would probably be very valuable.
He definitely could, you know, come, you know...
He can review the plans. Give us our plans, have them take a look at them.
Well, you know, he's the executive director, but I can't think of the guy's name, but whoever their engineer is on staff, you know, he's going to bring him as well, so, yeah.
Well, there is, unfortunately, the recommended appointments, and he still is an appointee, is Paul Kostecki.
Right.
So he's never been removed as an appointee, and there's, so that, there again, that would be the Board of Selectmen issue to do something with that. If you were to incline to bring on another member, would be to remove...
That's true. Paul was never replaced.
Right, exactly. But he was never removed off of...
Was he ever sworn in?
I don't think so.
If he was never sworn in, he was never part of the board, so. Some moot appointment.
I wasn't, were you sworn in today?
I think so.
Yeah. You didn't get sworn in?
I was.
No.
Didn't get your book?
Oh, we can throw your vote out for tonight.
Wait till he's done with his spreadsheet first.
Yeah. Hey, you know, hey, John, just slide them over to him now. You know what, you're right, it is not me.
I don't remember that, I got sworn in for finance and capital improvement.
Yeah, you just mumbled the words and...
You didn't read the fine print.
Maybe I did.
Well, unfortunately...
I'm sure I must have.
Unfortunately, that's what happens to too many people. Now, they just, well, I got sworn in, and they forget that they only got sworn in for one committee, and most of us are serving on two or three, and you have to get sworn in for every committee.
So, have we got a date for the next meeting?
Well, we have one last thing. Jack and I were asked to prepare a flyer or something for town meeting.
So we, yeah, so we each did our homework, and this is Bruce's, okay? And this, I had help. I happen to be related to a graphic artist.
Wow, it's like a bookmark.
I think both of them.
That'd be a good idea, actually.
And mine on the back has an explanation of all the items and what the problem is with them.
Yeah, Bruce's is more, mine requires money. Mine is, 1,000 of them is $229, so.
Wow.
Did you guys see the article in the newspaper?
No.
You didn't?
Yeah, I did.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, that was good, that was good.
You wrote?
No, the reporter was here. So I wrangled him, and when I was out at that plant with Kevin, I took a picture of that basket.
So Jack, is this Deerfield Green on it?
Changed out that picture to a different one?
My graphic artist, he just made it.
I think that looks like they're green.
Yeah.
Pass that down.
Pass that right down through.
The toilet was actually in the middle. It had all the things that you can't flush.
That's the basket.
They can put this in as a bookmark, isn't it?
2 days.
So the question is, we're pushing the timeline for town meeting. Do we want to do anything?
Do we have a budget to pay for it? Or are you going to pass the basket?
Hair.
You can probably go to Staples and get...
Hairbrushes.
100 made, I don't know, but you said about 100 of bookmarks was 200 and something.
1,000 of the bookmarks was $229 plus tax.
So $229.
If you ever do another one, add hair.
Well, actually, we could change it and...
Because people clean out their hairbrushes and stuff, and then they just put it in the toilet, and it comes through and winds and wraps and...
We could modify it if you want to...
No, it's not critical. You covered it.
We had to choose out of the whole long list, we had to choose a...
Right, you covered it.
The option is also is to put that in with the tax bill.
That's a good idea.
As long as it doesn't cost any more postage to me.
Comment on this?
Plus, some people probably will keep this as a bookmark, and then they will look at it.
Well, I think we ought to take the balance that you don't distribute at town meeting to the library.
Right, take them to the library and put them in a stand on the counter.
Take some to the frontier and give them to the kids.
Excellent idea. The Polish Club, you buy a drink, you hand them one of those.
Oh, they don't do that.
Yes, Bruce.
Bruce.
A comment on this, and I meant to speak to Kevin on this also, is a couple times when talking about stuff going down the drain, the comments, you know, one of them being grease.
Yeah.
And you've said a couple times, you know, pour it into a jar. And that scares me, because hot grease can explode a jar.
Yeah, you don't do it hot.
Change that to a can, please, whenever you mention it.
Or, yeah.
All right, then I'm going to have to change what I do at home, because...
And that's all, and you have a jar on this also.
You know...
Another way is to just let it cool.
I think it's very important.
I think I've seen it.
No, I agree, you're right.
You cool, you let it cool in your hand, and it solidifies. Then you wipe it out with paper towels. Waste basket.
It's better when into the can while it's still liquid.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Yeah.
Easiest way.
And I actually have photos I took on my phone, in case we decided we wanted to go ahead and try and institute something like that. Show the pan that's filled with grease, show the hand in there with the paper towel, and then the next picture is the thing clean with the hand, with the paper towel going into the trash can.
So we have about five, how many, 800 users, but half of them Deerfield Academy and...
880.
So about, if we get 500, can we get 500?
Right.
Yeah. So we can send them out twice.
We can put them in the tax bill, the bookmark.
You're talking about the bookmark. How about this?
That'd be a great handout.
That'd be a great handout at town hall.
Well, can't they print it on that printer?
Yeah, I mean, I...
Copy machine they got in there? Doesn't it print color also?
Yeah, it's pretty primitive.
And they will do front and back?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what you should do, I think, but...
And we could probably do 100 of them staples for, well, color is expensive, so...
You just use Kevin's code on the machine.
There's usually like, what, 250 people that go to the town meeting?
Yeah, there's a lot, so that's a lot of printing.
Actually, could use mosquito...
Money?
Maybe the pipe...
Use the mosquito money? So, if we're all set, then we're going to make a motion to adjourn.
Wait a minute, you need a date.
What's the next meeting?
Date.
Just set a date.
May 20th?
I will be out of town.
Why is that?
When is it?
May 20th, 20th, 21st, I'm going to be out of town.
What date?
I just said that, I'm sorry.
Hey, while you guys are debating about a thing, I got a kind of an off-the-wall question that somebody asked me. And the question was how can, if the people that are paying for anything that's got to do with wastewater treatment, why does the entire town vote on it? If they're not...
They don't.
Contributing. Oh, yes, they do.
It's a warrant article.
Which warrant article is that?
The one that transfers money from the one account to the...
To the wastewater treatment.
To my operating budgets and everything else?
Yeah.
So the entire town votes on that?
Right.
So that'd be like, you know where I'm coming from?
Yeah.
Well, so we can say if you're not, don't vote on this unless you use town sewer. But I mean, it's just a matter of it's not charging anybody money, it's just moving it.
But it's also a town asset.
Yeah, so, what was the date you guys wanted to do?
Oh, is it a town asset?
The town owns all the building, the town owns all the...
When is the thing at UMass?
Can't use the money for anything but the sewer thing.
UMass.
Yes, the
board?
I don't know.
The town property is...
May 10th, okay. I thought it was at UMass, I don't know. Thank you.
No, we're just appropriating money to move it from one area to another.
Yeah.
Right?
When?
18th at 6.
May 18th?
Kevin, can you make May 18th at 6?
18th, that is a Thursday.
I just picked 20, I just said 12, it's a Saturday.
5/18, and...
Is that going to affect your...
5/18 will work for me.
Okay.
Right, is that Skims, Kip?
I don't...
It's Thursday.
Yeah.
Yeah, 5/18 will work, it's 11.
When's CIPC? May, when do we say?
May 16th, the CIPC, Tuesday.
Okay, we've got to go over this stuff, Kevin, quick.
Do you want to do the 11th?
Yep.
We did the 18th.
What's that?
Is, oh, I was just wondering, Board of Oversight for Skelmes?
I'm fine.
You're fine?
Yes.
Okay. The 18th, then?
18th, yeah.
18, and what time?
6 o'clock.
Okay.
When did you say CIPC was, John?
How's it doing?
I don't know, we're getting it at home. Oh, 16?
Yes.
I don't know, you said it was okay. I didn't say it was okay.
I said the 18th.
Oh, yeah, I know, but I didn't know it was the mail. I wrote it down somewhere.
And mail them.
Yeah, I got it. Can't find my note.
I think we should print 1,000, because I don't think it would be half to do.
Anyway.
No, I don't think so, too.
And then you could have them on the counter here.
No, you can't.
You could have them in the last, the first of all, I took a couple of them right here in the library.
I took a couple of them, but I looked for them in here, and I couldn't find them.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, but unfortunately, Jack, what's going to happen is half of the non-use are going to grab it.
I know.
Because of mine.
True.
Now, so.
Well, let's hold on.
Well, but on the other hand, you know, Joe Smith's kid goes over to his friend's house and flushes whatever, you know?
If the sewer user's got it, it'd be one thing. The non-sewer user, it's going to get grabbed up.
So we're going to meet the 18th at 6 o'clock.
18th next meeting. Does anyone want to make a motion to adjourn?
Yes. It's all made.
Even then, it may go in the.
Just say second.
We're still May 18th, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Want to second that motion?
I'll second it.
Hand it to whoever answers the door.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.